You have to look at a 3D printer, I think, and take a step back and realize it's a little factory in a box.
For this particular project, I was using zebrafish embryos, and then I found out that the pieces that were coming out from the 3D printer are actually very toxic to the fish. A lot of them die, or if they survive, they suffer from really severe abnormalities.
At one point, 3D printers were fairly rare and expensive. They're getting to the point where you can have them in schools, in research labs like my own, and even in people's homes. Now, when you look at it as a little 3D printer that looks like a toaster, it's non-threatening. And the chemistry that goes into taking a liquid, shining light on it, and turning it into a solid, it's pretty extreme chemistry. It can generate liters of waste that is contaminated with things that are known to be toxic. You could be exposing yourself to really who knows what. We need to occasionally take a step back and ask about the materials that these printers are making and make sure that in the schools or in the homes that they're being dealt with in a responsible way.